You are listening to the Hiking Radio Network, where we talk the walk with shows by hikers about hikers for everybody.
Welcome to the Trail Dames podcast, where we speak with women who love to dance upon this earth. Hey everyone, welcome back to the Trail Dames podcast. If you've been listening for a while, I hope you've been enjoying my Appalachian Trail journal entries. I've been sharing with you tales of my own attempt at a through hike. Well, you might remember I mentioned several times my awesome friend, Jan Leitschuh. Leitschuh was a horse whisperer who one day got bitten by the AT bug, and she hiked the same year I did. And while she was doing her hike, she kept an extraordinary journal. She never published that journal, but she gave me permission to share it with you here on the Trail Dames podcast. The stories will come back in the future, but now for the next few months, I want you to take a trip on the AT with Leitschuh. She experiences every second of her hike with depth and with wonder, and she shares it beautifully. I know you're going to love it. My name is Anna. All my friends call me Mudbutt, and today I'm introducing you to my friend Leitschuh. Thanks for listening to the Trail Dames podcast. Mudbutt here. Before I read Leitschuh's journal entry today to you, I want to put a shout out for an amazing website. If you don't know about trailjournals.com, I want you to go visit it at some point. Today, especially in her journal entry, Leitschuh references several other hikers that hiked with us in 2003. Their journals can also be found there. In fact, that's what the site is. It's a site of nothing but journals of hikers all over the world for years and years and years, any trail you can imagine, any age, any gender, from any place, they are all there on trailjournals.com. And you can really find just great fertilizer for all your dreams there. So after you're done listening to today's podcast episode, go check it out, trailjournals.com. Now, Thursday, January 9th, Jan's Leitschuh AT Journal pre-hike number 7. We 2003 hikers are very chatty lately. You can feel the excitement growing on our 2003 e-list. It's called Hikers RS. Sometimes the conversations veer into deep water, as if we were all already sitting around the campfire. People are having to sort out their motivations as friends and relatives want to know, why? Why are you going on a 6-month walk? Why are you doing this? It's very rich and meaty stuff. Today on the E-list, someone asked why. Why would people like him, like all of us, quit their jobs and go hike the AT? Why? Asked Jonathan. It's quite an intimate question, really. It strikes at the heart of who we believe ourselves to be. Very meaty indeed. Several of the hikers shared their answers, and I'm sharing them here with you. Jonathan wrote, "For what seemed like the 1,000,000th time, a coworker asked me yesterday, why would anyone in their right mind sell a house and quit a job to walk through the woods for 5 months? Once again, I had no reasonable, sensible, or logical response. Just the visceral feeling to know that I had to try this. I just sat and said, oh, you know, I really just like the outdoors and hiking, etc. While everyone around me had that same expression on their face that I've seen so many times. That look that says, yeah, I knew he was really a little touched. Later after work, I lay awake thinking and asking myself over and over again, why? Why do I need to do this so much? See, I think that deep down, Jonathan knows that visceral feeling, quote unquote, he says, though the answer may not make much sense to anyone else around him or even to him, but he knows it's there. He ignores it at his own peril, and I think he knows that too. My fellow AT03 classmate Ted, aka Soul Man, he puts this after every one of his posts. It was on the first day of May in the year 1769 that I resigned my domestic happiness for a time and left my family and peaceable habitation on the Yadkin River in North Carolina to wander through the wilderness of America. Daniel Boone. It begs that same question. Why? In response, another O3 lister, Mark, a.k.a. Toot, he quoted from a trail journal by Yogi. Yogi is a Pacific Crest Trail hiker and an AT 1999 hiker. The American dream, Yogi says, no longer worked for her. She said, I still buy into some of the quote-unquote American dream, but a lot of it is no longer fitting for me at this time in my life. If I had dependents, I might feel differently. But if the American dream fits you, I say, go for it. Everybody's inner call is different. Hike your own hike, as they say, as long as you are hiking it. I've only quoted parts of Yogi's essay here, but the rest can be seen in her journals. Yogi wrote, thru-hikers are good people. We're a tribe of souls who have chosen a lifestyle which is very different from most people. Problem is that most of us have friends and family who try to protect their happiness, and they try to project their happiness onto us. They assume we can't be happy unless we have what they have. We have a different lifestyle, so we must be doing it wrong. No matter how much we try to explain it, they'll never understand. We're not irresponsible. We are not doing it wrong. We are grown up, and we are happy. We're living a healthy lifestyle. We're exactly where we want to be. On the trail, in the hiking community, we are surrounded by friends who do get it. Well, this is LiteShoe again here. And after reading all that, I've thought about the why all morning. Some of this is ground I have plowed before. I still don't have that quick and easy soundbite for why. But I do know more about what motivates me. So I posted this in our group. Jonathan had asked, why do I need to do this so much? I've wrestled with this question too. I finally saw what it was, and I wrote my why in my journal. I've hesitated about putting it out there because exposing one's interior life, it invites cynicism and sarcasm. I've learned that if one isn't vigilant and courageous, taking this negativity to heart can shut down access to what is sometimes called that small, still voice. I think the why of it is bigger than just what we, the class of 03, are feeling. I think the impulse is ageless and universal. We are plugged into the same restlessness that sparked migrations through the eons. Why else would primitive peoples with low technology leave their predictable homelands and cross unknown deserts and oceans? I mean, I'm a weenie by comparison. At least I have maps. The little voice niggles, whispering, what's more important than mere survival? There's something else out there that's important too. I'm willing to bet many here have heard that voice, whether they trust it or not. It's a tender yet persistent little thing, like a flower pushing up through concrete. Why aren't we O3ers all doing the 9-to-5 survival grind this year? The little voice will always have its out, whether we work with it or not. It bubbles, we push it down, it makes us crazy. But in the long run, it's really less hassle to just work with it. Why? Why do I need to do this so much? How about awe? Awe is where it's at. It feeds us. Everyone has their own reasons, but for me, it's awe. In truth, we don't need to go anywhere to see this. I do recognize that much. Seeking is a trap. There's awe in our everyday life, too. But for me, at least, it's easy to take it for granted, to overlook it, to get bored or cynical, to get in my head too much and miss the reality that is all around me. No concepts or beliefs are needed for awe. Awe just is awe. It stops us in our tracks. It sags our jaws. So I take the journey to wake me up. Someday I'm going to learn how to stay awake in everyday life, to become innocent again with wisdom this time. That's my truth anyway, and I'm sticking to it like a virgin shoe. P.S. Not working for half a year, it's kind of a kick too. Jan Leitschuh, AT class of 03. See what I mean? Isn't her writing fantastic? Like I mentioned, she hasn't published these journal entries, and I just really appreciate her sharing them with us. But you know what she has done? Before she did her AT through hike, she did a through hike of the Vermont Long Trail, and she did write a book about that. It's called The Ordinary Adventurer, Hiking Vermont's Long Trail, a Primer for Baby Adventurers and Other Musings on the Nature of the Journey. You can find it on Amazon. I have put the link in the show notes, and I hope that you will go and order it because it is wonderful. I want to say a quick thank you to Steve, aka Mighty Blue. He's our fantastic producer. He is also the creator of the Hiking Radio Network. If you're enjoying the Trail Names podcast, definitely go check out the network. All the podcasts there are wonderful. And if you are enjoying our podcast, do me a favor. Share it with your friends and family. Share it on your social media. We want to get the word out about the Trail Names podcast so we can help inspire women to get out and hike, hike, hike. My name is Anna. All my friends call me Mudbutt. And I really appreciate you listening. Now go hit the trail.